The PYP7 mini exhibition, an event that gives us the opportunity to exhibit the elements of an IB program in which we inquire, research, find out, make connections, and come up with conclusions to make this world a better one.
Our mini exhibition this year is about biodiversity. Our unit is under the transdisciplinary theme, Sharing the Planet. In our theme, we were engaged in a collaborative inquiry process that involves identifying, investigating, and offering solutions to real-life issues or problems.
In the past weeks, our learning journey has been fueled by a passion to understand biodiversity. We've inquired into questions like, what is biodiversity? Why is it important? How do different ecosystems thrive? And what role do we play in preserving this incredible diversity?
Our journey started with a big idea. Biodiversity is all about keeping the balance between different living things. We inquired into different ecosystems where animals live. We wanted to learn more. We inquired into different ecosystems where animals live. We discovered how animals and plants rely on each other to survive in nature. They work together as a team. We found out that when people interact with nature, it can sometimes upset this balance. We realized how important it is to take care of our environment and all of the creatures that live in it.
Biodiversity is essential because it makes our planet unique and ensures that ecosystems work well. It's like having a big family with lots of different ecosystems, each playing a special role to keep them balanced.
Too about extinction. And let me tell you, and you kind of think this would be obvious, going extinct is a bad thing. And driving yourselves extinct in 70 million years, that's the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard. At least we had an asteroid. What's your excuse? You're headed for a climate disaster, and yet every year governments spend hundreds of billions of public funds on fossil fuel subsidies. Imagine if we had spent hundreds of billions per year subsidizing giant meteors. That's what you're doing right now. Think of all the other things you can do with that money. Around the world, people are living in poverty. Don't you think helping them would make more sense than, I don't know, paying for the demise of your entire species? Let me be real for a second. You've got a huge opportunity right now. As you rebuild your economies and bounce back from this pandemic, this is humanity's big chance. So here's my wild idea. Don't choose extinction. Save your species before it's too late. It's time for you humans to stop making excuses and start making changes. Thank you.
Their own destiny.
Little did they know their actions would bring both prosperity and threat to the planet's biodiversity.
How is that a threat?
How about we look to the scientists, Tomar, Yusuf, and Laila, to explain.
Woo!
that there are at least 8 million different species of plants and animals on Earth, we're all part of this incredible world. All species, including humans, are interdependent in some interesting and unexpected ways.
Our story begins with a special focus on gray wolves. A long time ago, gray wolves roamed freely in the United States.
I am the mighty gray wolf, once ruler of the land. And I am the peaceful deer, enjoying our forest home.
But oh no, humans arrived!
Oh, what a nice place to settle and create our community. Let's build a city and grow our farms.
But those wolves are a threat to our farm animals.
Don't worry, we'll take care of
this. Because of this, we started hunting wolves. In the early 1900s, wolves were nearly extinct in the United States.
But humans, this is a mistake, Rabbi.
Then realized their mistake without wolves.
Deer populations exploded.
They started munching on young trees, and soon beavers couldn't build their dams.
The impact continued as riverbanks were destroyed, affecting many other species.
This isn't just a wolf story. It's happening all around the world. Species are disappearing faster than ever.
Imagine sea lions. They love to eat different kinds of fish. But if some fish disappear, it gets tough for them.
And it's not just animals. When humans cut down forests or introduce new plants, we mess up the balance for everyone.
Why does it matter to us? Because we're not living in a bubble. We need healthy ecosystems for food, water, and air. We're sharing the planet!
جميع أشكال الحياة على سطح الأرض، وهي النظام الذي يدرس العلاقات المتبادلة للكائنات الحية بين بعضها البعض. أولاً، البيئة وبين الكائنات الحية والبيئة المحيطة. ثانياً،
لقد كنت أنا وأصدقائي في الصف الرابع الابتدائي في مادة اللغة العربية والدراسات الاجتماعية بالبحث عن الحيوانات والأنشطة في البيئات المختلفة. وكيف تؤثر وتتأثر بالبيئة وإليكم بعض المشاهد التي توضح أهم ما يميز هذه البيئات.
أنا البيئة الزراعية أن تهزم الأرض الخصبة ويوجد في العديد من مصادر المياه العذبة التي تساعد في رعي المحاصيل التي تمتلكها من الطعام. يميزني العديد من العناصر المختلفة مثل
أنا الدجاج ونيابة عن أصدقائي في البيئة الزراعية، فكل منا لها دور في مساعدة صديقنا الفلاح في أعمال الزراعية مثل تنظيف التربة وحرس الأرض، كما أننا مصدر بروتيني له ولأسرته.
يساعد التغيير بين الفصول على تنوع الخضروات والفاكهة خلال العام.
وأنا أهم ما يميز البيئة الزراعية، حيث أغسل أرض الفلاح باللون الأخضر ليستفيد مني الإنسان والحيوانات.
أنا الفلاح طيب القلب، وتختلف لهجتي عن لهجات البيئات الأخرى، ويظهر بيئتنا التعاون والرحمة فيما بيننا.
Yeah.
to different amazing biomes like the rainforest, tundra, desert, grassland, and marine.
And guess what? Some animals in these places are endangered. They need our help to stay safe and happy.
That's when we ask, how can we fulfill our human needs while also preserving biodiversity?
Let's meet some of the endangered animals and learn how we can make a big difference. Excuse me, Panda. I need this to build our home.
Stop! We need this to survive.
What's wrong, Panda? We need shelter for ourselves.
But building your home is destroying our home, our habitat.
What is your home?
This wonderful place. It is called the desert forest. It's fantastic, with cool weather and lots of tall green trees. It is home to many different plants and animals. We love it because we have lots of yummy bamboos to eat, and we feel nice and comfortable with the cool breeze.
But you humans are coming back and destroying our home. We need to help protect our home and all the other animals that live there. There are as few as 2,500 left of us now.
But I must point out that humans need these resources from the forest, such as wood for building homes, paper for writing. Do you think it's important for us to use these resources?
We understand your point, but it's important to find a balance. Deforestation is affecting our habitats, affecting not only humans, but also countless other animals and plants. We must respect the forest biodiversity and assure sustainability.
I see where you're coming from. So what action do you suggest we take to protect your habitat and get what we need?
It's important to promote sustainable practices such as reforestation, selective logging, and using recycled material.
Governments and individuals support organizations that protect the temperate forest and its living including us red bandits.
What are the suggestions, Brenda? We must work together to keep the temperate forest healthy for future generations. Thank you for sharing your perspective.
Must find ways to sustainably use ocean resources while keeping it healthy.
It's a special type of aWributes elephant. Stick up. Do you want one?
Yes, please.
Easy peasy. There's an elephant over there. Let's go take its tusks.
Ouch! Hurting us and the actions are causing harm to our savannah home.
Can you tell us more about your savannah home?
Savannah is a vast grassland with lots of trees. It's a beautiful place for me and my family. You can find animals here like zebras and lions. It's not too hot or too cold, just right for these animals to roam around.
But your actions and habitat destruction and poaching are threatening our existence.
We sometimes need land for agriculture and development, and these tusks are very precious. We use them to make beautiful things, so as we can do.
Use the land as food to stop illegal logging, prevent poaching, and find an alternative to others.
Most important thing to think about elephants. You must find a good balance between building things and surviving and making animals safe.
So here are some of the other endangered animals.
Hello, what's about me?
I'm your good old tree. I'm the producer. I belong in the forest and in the woods, as well as in your backyards and gardens. You probably see me every day, so you don't even think about me. I help to clean your air and I offer you oxygen, yet you chop me off every day for your houses, for your papers, and for your manufacturing, and many other reasons, as if I'm not important to you. Many plant species are endangered too. I agree with my fellow friends that an action of violence must happen so we can all flourish together. Otherwise,
these list of plants will become extinct.
Thank you. Others call me Mother Nature. I've been here for over 4.5 billion years, 22,500 times longer. I don't really need people, but people need me. Yes, your future depends on me. When I thrive, you thrive. When I falter, you falter. Or worse, but I've been here for eons. I have fed species greater than me, and I have starved species greater than me. My oceans, my soil, my flowing streams, my forests, they cannot take you or leave you. How you choose to live each day, whether you regard or disregard, doesn't really matter to you. One way or the other, your actions will determine your fate, not mine. I am nature. I will go on. I am prepared to evolve. Are you?
We understand how human activities impact biodiversity, leading to the loss of species, ecosystems, and essential natural resources. We have a responsibility to maintain the balance of biodiversity.
Why is it important to keep the balance in nature? Can we just ignore it and let future generations handle it?
We need a lot of different plants and animals on Earth to help us survive. But right now, we are hurting them. In the past 50 years, our actions have made many plants and animals disappear. We destroyed their homes, made their populations get smaller, and even made some species go extinct.
When we lose biodiversity, it doesn't just affect plants, it also affects people. Many communities, especially in poor countries, depend on different kinds of plants and animals to live. Cutting down forests, making the air and water dirty, and changing the climate all hurt these plants and animals. This makes life harder for people too.
Oh no, does that mean there's no hope?
Remember the story about the gray wolves?
We can fix some of the damage we've caused.
In the 1990s, people brought back wolves. Magic happened. Deer stopped overgrazing, trees grew back. Riverbanks stabilized and beavers returned.
So if we work together, recognize the value of biodiversity, and act fast, we can make the world a better place for everyone.
Oh, we see.
that.
Goals are a set of
goals that help people all around the world work together to make the Earth a better place for everyone to live.
Those goals are managed and overseen by the United Nations, with countries and organizations from all around the world working together to make them a reality by the year 2030.
In order to achieve a sustainable world where all ecosystems flourish, we are seeing need to take action towards SDG 30, 40, and 50, which target life on land, life below water, as well as climate change.
My apologies, ladies and gentlemen. We have some breaking news from our international GPS representatives.
Good morning, everyone. It's Thursday, February 15th, 2024. Welcome to the GPS News. I'm Banan Kodi.
And I'm Hassan Matas.
Today we have some exciting news about how the United Nations and countries all around the world are working to protect biodiversity.
The United Nations is like a team of countries that come together to solve important problems around the world, and one of the problems they're focusing on is protecting biodiversity.
That's correct. They want to make sure that animals and plants have a safe place to live. They want to stop pollution, deforestation, and other things that harm nature.
And they hold a conference called the CBD COP, which is like a special plan to protect biodiversity.
Exactly. The CBD has rules and targets to help countries take care of plants and animals. It says that we should understand why they're disappearing, reduce the things that hurt them, and make sure everyone benefits from nature.
And guess what? In 2022, during this COP, they adopted the Kunming-Montreal Global Biodiversity Framework.
Sure.
Who will share the actions their governments are taking. Let's meet them!
Lele, would you like to begin with us today?
Thank you, Madam Esser. With you today, Lele Hammond. I am the GPIS representative Canada. Canada does only host COP15 in Montreal. Canada has also created national parks, protected areas, and wildlife reserves to keep nature safe. They're committed to protecting marine ecosystems and species too. Thank you for joining me. Now let's move to a country known for its unique wildlife and landscapes, Australia.
Hello there with you, Langley from Australia. Australia is doing an amazing job protecting its oceans and the famous Great Barrier Reef. They set up a special marine protected areas to keep these places safe and healthy. Thank you for joining me. Now let's check on Germany, a country dedicated to environmental protection.
Hello everyone, I'm Amy. I'm the GPS representative in Germany. I'm glad to share that Germany has policies that promote sustainable land use and protect natural habitats. They work with other countries to fight against climate change and protect animals and plants. Moving on to Asia in China.
Thank you, Eileen. With you today, Asia. I'm the GPS representative in China. In China, their government has been doing a lot to help giant pandas, like protecting their homes, feeding them, and releasing them into the wild. They even made laws to stop people hunting pandas. All these efforts have really paid off. In 2016, a group called the International Union said that pandas moved them from being endangered to vulnerable, which means they're safer now. Moving on to Ismail in France.
La France est le troisième plus grand pays d'Europe. La France a décidé de développer une économie sans pollution, de protéger et de restaurer la nature. La France a marqué sa volonté de faire entrer la biodiversité dans le champ de toutes les politiques publiques. L'engagement pris en 2012 s'est traduit par le dépôt du projet de loi des quatre pour la biodiversité. biodiversité. Cette loi a permis plusieurs avancées. 1. Création de l'Agence française pour la biodiversité. 2. Protection des sols d'intérêt général. 3. Interdire certains genres de pesticides. 4. Renforcer les outils de protection des espèces en danger. En France, il y a des associations de protection de la faune et de la flore comme ASPA, Évoluver et les Amis de la Terre. Et maintenant, avec Youssef de l'Égypte.
مرحبا بكم معكم يوسف صبقا من مصر. في مصر قمنا بتأسيس المحميات الطبيعية والمناطق المحمية للحفاظ على النظم البيئية المتنوعة والحياة البرية. ومن هذه المناطق محمية رأس محمد ومحمية سيوة. وتقوم مصر بتعزيز التشريعات البيئية لمكافحة الصيد غير المشروع وحماية الحياة البرية. وتشارك مصر بفاعلية في الجهود الدولية لمواجهة التحديات المناخية COP27 وتحفيز التعاون الدولي لتحقيق التكامل في جهود مواجهة التغير المناخي. يوسف صقر من مصر.
These countries and many others are taking action to protect our planet's beautiful biodiversity. Thank you for joining us for this special news report.
Wow, it's really awesome to hear all the cool things countries are trying to do to help save biodiversity. Makes me feel happy knowing that everyone is working together to help save our planet's biodiversity.
But what do you think we individuals can do to help balance things out?
We may not be able to begin with big changes, but we must begin somewhere. Remember, preserving biodiversity begins with you.
After making some conclusions and connections throughout our inquiry process, we looked into different departments to explore the actions taken by our local community at GPIS. To help biodiversity, we asked each department, what biodiversity-friendly practices are you doing and what suggestions do you have for enhancing biodiversity moving forward?
We paid a visit to the administration office, ID department, art department, library audit department, as well as the student council leaders.
GPIS has gone digital by using ManageBack. Consent forms are now emailed to parents rather than being sent with students, which helps conserve wildlife habitats and forests.
The IT department and the school community are very keen on reducing the paper. They have reached 200 packs per month instead of 250 this month.
GPIS has created a makerspace room where the community can add reusable and recyclable material, reducing waste and supporting biodiversity.
With the support of the student council members, GPIS collaborated with the and so we can recover. Now each class has boxes for plastic and paper, making sure Vikia can collect and recycle them every month, supporting biodiversity.
Moving forward, GPS departments have also suggested more ways to support biodiversity.
They suggested making GPIS branded water bottles rather than using plastic ones.
They also suggested installing solar panels and starting a small recycling center in school.
Additionally, they want to teach planting lessons to promote the idea of preserving biodiversity to students.
We were happy to learn about GPS actions. Biodiversity.
We want to keep making GPS a place that supports biodiversity.
We've learned how important biodiversity is for our planet, but right now it's still in danger. Our actions have caused a big drop in biodiversity, and we need to stop that.
To help protect biodiversity, we have to think about our choices every day.
Remember, even small actions can make a big difference. Let's work together to protect biodiversity.
I
I promise I will use recyclable materials. I promise I will reduce the usage of paper. I promise to plant more. I promise to unplug the charger when it's not in use. I promise I'll fix my phone. I promise to use paper for both sides. I promise to reduce the amount of plastic that I use. I promise I'll take care of animals.
I promise I'll stop accepting or buying any ivory gifts.
I promise I will never pick flowers. I promise I'll receive energy. I'll try using reusable things like a lunchbox.
Without enough to eat, who am I to be blind?
pieces of paper, we're going to ask you to scan the padded QR code to write your action instead of writing it on paper. Please find the action chart and follow the instructions. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you, PYP7. It was amazing. Lovely. Would you like to say anything to your parents? No? Yes? Thank you. Thank you for coming. Yes, definitely. Thank you for coming. Thank you. Thank you for the hard work. Thank you for being so happy and joyful and proud of what you have presented and of all the learning that you have acquired. And definitely we cannot leave without thanking the people behind all of this. Thank you so much, teachers. Thank you very much, Noor. I didn't see you. I thought you were not yet on stage. Zoraya? Sara Ibrahim? Dua Shaha? Aya Shaheen, Sadaif, Nehid, Madame Nehid, Madame Soha, and definitely, last but not least, Miss Mai, sorry. We have to thank all the organizers, agenda administration, and so forth. However, before we leave, it is your responsibility, PYP7, to make sure that people around you, your families, your parents, your friends, take the action that you insisted that they get to know. So you are the biodiversity police that we are sending out to the world. Okay? Thank you all so much for coming.